Welcome to the Austin Method, where we help you develop the skills of square dance.
This is 201, lead right or left. As we're often wont to, let's go to the definition. The definition here is that it is a starting formation is a couple. Any couple, half sashayed couple, boy-boy couple, girl-girl couple, normal couple, any couple of dancers can lead right or left. Working as a unit, a couple, you move forward 90 degrees in an arc to face the wall to either your right or your left. It's pretty straightforward. There's lead right. We can do it from lots of different formations. Let me show you another formation. Everybody's going to lead right, and there it is. So lead right, lead left. Pretty straightforward. Let's go back to the main screen. The hardest part about lead right and lead left is just figuring out which direction to go. When actually dancing from a dead stop, lead right or lead left, you'll see everybody take a little pause and the caller give you a little extra time. Let's look at the stats. Technically, the number of beats is 5. But as I mentioned, the caller will often give you one or two extra to make that decision about which way is right and which way is left. It is not gender specific, does not matter who the dancers are or even what the couple is comprised of. It can be boy, boy, girl, girl, half sashayed, or normal couples. Frame doesn't really play into it except reminding your partner which way you're going to go if you're the one that figures it out first. Definitely has flow. It has rotational flow. It has momentum flow. It even has a little veering flow. And you always turn exactly 90 degrees to face the next wall, either to the right or the left. So there's the stats on it. Something to keep in mind is if you're close together, you often have to kind of scrunch and pull your shoulders in to breathe past each other. So you can see it gets really close. Sometimes in actual dancing, it can get really close and you have to just kind of pull your shoulders in and breathe in motion to get past each other. This dance sequence has a lot of flow built into it. So wheel around leads very nicely into lead left or lead right, reverse wheel around and wheel around. This sequence has a lot of flow, but it also has counter flow. So it has lead rights and lead left. So hopefully it doesn't make you dizzy. You're not going to, in regular dancing, see this many lead lefts and rights and wheel arounds, but we're trying to demonstrate how flow leads into it and to give you some good experience with it. Too much flow is called overflow, which is what makes you dizzy. So if this choreography makes you dizzy, stop and try again in a few minutes. Your brain does acclimate to the turning, and you'll get less dizzy as you become more comfortable with the sequence. Callers do try to avoid overflow, but it does happen in real life as well.
201, lead right or left, form up as facing couples. Bow to your partner. Lead left. Wheel around. There's strong flow here. Don't fight it. Go with it. Lead left. Wheel around. Lead right. Reverse wheel around. Lead right. Reverse wheel around. Half sashay. Lead right. Reverse wheel around. Lead right. Reverse wheel around. Lead left. Wheel around. Lead left. You turn back. And you should be home.
Thank you for visiting the Austin Method. We hope to see you on the dance floor soon.